Over the weekend, there was a viral video featuring two groups of protesters near the Lincoln Monument in Washington, D.C. There was a group of white, all boys Catholic school students protesting about how much they hate abortion. And then there was a group of Native Americans. And the video that went viral featured a Native American who was surrounded by MAGA hat wearing white students. Now, it appeared that the students had been taunting the Native American man, but once we learned a little more about the context, the story changed a little bit. So here's a CBS News report that fully highlights what went down.
A high school junior from Covington Catholic High School in Kentucky inches away while Sandman's schoolmates chanted. It seemed Phillips was being treated disrespectfully. Within hours, more videos surfaced.
What the hell is you see of crackers with Make America Great hat on?
The kids from Kentucky had been taunted by a small group of African American provocateurs known as the Black Hebrew Israelites.
This is a bunch of future school shooters.
The Covington kids shouted over them with what they say were school cheers, dozens jumping up and down. Which is when Phillips walked toward the group of students, beating his drum, he says, to calm a combustible situation.
What did you do when America was tearing itself apart? Did you turn your head, you walk away? Or did you go in there, into the midst of it, and say, this is wrong?
So there's a lot to break down here. There's a lot of damage to report because the media appears to have jumped on the original viral video, which had been tweeted out by an account that's now been suspended on Twitter because there are allegations that it is a fake account. It's been around for only a few months. It has a pretty large following. And I don't know without a shadow of a doubt whether this was a fake account or not, but I will mention that the same news organizations that obsess over fake news and how it impacted the 2016 election seem to keep falling prey to fake news stories, right? Like the idea of journalism is to go to the original source and figure out whether or not the original source is credible. If there's any reason to believe that the source is suspicious, you don't run the story, but everyone ran the story.
Right. There's a lot happening in this, and I am like I've been on that trip to the National Mall and the area between the Lincoln Memorial and the Washington Monument, and there's a lot going on, and there's always people protesting. Things that I'm certain of is that it's a complicated situation. Another thing I'm certain of is like I looked at that group of kids, and they're being jerks. And there have been folks that have chronicled that entire day of what happened and showed the Covington boys, as they have come to be known, just being kind of jerks to everyone. And I say this is more of something in line with the like Gillette ad, where people are saying like your excuse for the boys is boys will be boys will be boys will be boys. When in reality, I tweeted out over the weekend and got a lot of people like pushing back. I wasn't saying what brought this on or anything, but specifically it was, I know what that kid is thinking. The kid who's staring it down, and that is, this is a kid who does, if you asked him, what are you doing right now? He would not have an answer. It would not be a good answer. If he had something to say, he would have said it to that guy. But what he knows in that moment is that whatever he's doing is making the other equally clueless idiots clap, and that's why he's doing it. And he's been doing that all day probably by buying a MAGA hat when he's on vacation or on this trip, and just generally trying to provoke people, because at that age, whether it's through racism or sexism, like those kids should be taught better than to do what they're doing, which is to just get a reaction.
Yeah, you nailed it, because everyone who talks about this story wants to pick which side is right and which side is wrong, when in reality, there was bad behavior on all sides, with the exception of the Native American man, right? So Nathan Phillips. And the reason why I say that is, it was a bad idea for him to get in between the protesters, but he had good intent. He didn't mean to go in there and cause any problems. He saw these Hebrew Israelites getting a little too, I guess, provocative with these students. He goes in there and he tries to defuse the situation, but the exact opposite happened. So even though he had good intent, he probably should have thought about, you know, how are people gonna react if I get in between them in the middle of this very tense moment? Again, no story is black and white. There is always nuance to it. Oftentimes you don't have a good side. Oftentimes you have two bad actors. Sometimes you have two good actors that were put in a negative situation, taken out of context, whatever it is. My point is the media needs to do its due diligence and let the story breathe before running with it. And we also as Americans need to understand, like, there is a little bit of an online mob, right?
Yeah.
Where it's like, let's destroy them, let's dox them.
Well,
no, like, let's take a moment to figure out what's really going on and then decide how we can turn this into a teachable moment rather than let's destroy everyone's lives.
Yeah, it started with like a now this video mm-hmm. and everyone kind of jumps on it to be like, I want to talk about this. And this is what you got.
Thank you very much for watching this clip from the Damage Report. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell on YouTube to get notifications of our new videos. And of course, you can catch the full Damage Report live every weekday at 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific on TYT Network on YouTube TV.